the good old days. Maybe that's something we've been longing for a bit more as we have gone through this year. Let's talk about that for just a moment. Stay tuned. I remember conversations with my grandpa growing up about his childhood and his days as he started off farming as a young man. I remember him talking about two horses, Toots and Pickles, if I remember right. Funny names for horses, but whatever. And enjoyed regaling those days with him and hearing about his childhood and the things that he experienced. Oftentimes, as we grow older, we often appreciate the good old days. I know as my wife and I were chatting some time ago about, we listen to country music from time to time and talking about the fact that, you know, we like the good old days when the country music was good back in the late 80s and early 90s. You know, there's some aspect in that particular time period of our life that we long for that is now missing, whatever it might be. And it varies based upon who you're talking to and, of course, how old they are. In today's culture, with the chaos that 2020 has been, the good old days might just be, what, the previous year, 2019, and not experiencing everything that we've been through this year. But you know, it's had a vast impact on a variety of people. I think of particularly being in the EMS world, the suicide and depression rates that have skyrocketed in these days because of some of the isolation stuff. I was yesterday just noticing the impact it was even having on my own kids. Of course, we're preparing for them to go back to school. They got to wear masks 5 days a week. And as we were getting out of our vehicle, last night we were getting a couple of things for the house, and one of the kids had made the remark as we were getting on their masks, saying, "Do we have to wear this again?" Yes, yeah, we do. For the time period that we're in right now, we just got to put up with it for a little while longer. And just the, you know, underestimating, I guess, or not thinking about the impact that this has even had on them. And you know, we long perhaps for those good old days, times when we aren't going through these things. But as I've been thinking through these things this week and in the past weeks and months, I wonder this: what's God's purpose in this? You know, we may be longing for the good old days, but for the church in particular, God is still good, is he not? And God is still working out our good, all things for our good, even these circumstances that frustrate us, that may make us angry, that may have put us into awkward situations and circumstances that we don't particularly like. God is still working out our good. And I wonder, and this has been on my mind, and a question on my mind is, what is God using these days for in preparation for the church? Paul and I were just chatting a few moments ago and remarking that we may, in fact, next year look back on this year and say, "Hey, I missed the good old days." It's all a matter of perspective, right? And the things that we're going through presently. And so, as tempted as we are to be constantly focused on these things, let's focus on what? On what God's doing in our lives. Let's focus on what he is teaching us now. We can look back and long for the good old days so much so that we forget or we aren't looking purposefully at what God is doing now. You know, circumstances have changed. Changed a variety of the ways, simply the way we go shopping, the way we interact with one another. Right now, we're not sure whether or not to give somebody a handshake or a high five or a fist bump or do elbows or something like that. Or even, you know, the passing, do I even say hi with somebody? Might they be offended or think I'm, you know, too much in their bubble or something like that? It has changed things drastically. It's changed the way the church does ministry in some respects. But you know what? It hasn't changed. I'm thinking through here at Grace, it hasn't changed our vision, is it? We're still a church of disciples, making disciples, reaching our community with the hope of Christ, and commissioning disciples to the unreached world. That has not changed. Now, the facets and the functions that those things take place in may, but our vision is still the same. Our mission is still the same, to love God and love others. Our purpose is still the same, to exalt him, to equip one another, to edify one another, and ultimately to evangelize the lost. And of course, our message is still the same, isn't it? Throughout the gospel message, it is still by grace through faith in Christ alone, isn't it? Those things remain the same. Facets of them, or the forms, if you will, of how those things happen may change, but those things remain the same. And I keep wondering, what is God using these days for in preparing the church for what may yet be coming to us? Paul and I were also talking about Russia here recently, and the fact that, you know, as we are fighting in some respects, I know especially on the West Coast, of being able to meet. In places like Russia, they haven't been able to meet for a long time. But you know what these days have presented them with? Unique opportunities for evangelism. They aren't meeting in their church building right now, but they have doors have opened exponentially for them in a place that is normally completely prohibits evangelism. They have opened exponentially, so much so as they serve through their food banks and the church and things like that, they are able to share the gospel message. This has opened a door and an opportunity that the good old days would not have. And so we look and we watch and we wait to see what God is doing even in these days. Yes, we may long for those days, but we understand what God is working right now in and through us. How is he at work? That's for us to decipher and to understand. And let's do this, so let's be sure that we're a part of his work, wherever it is, and whatever it involves us doing. Our vision, our mission, our message, our purpose have not changed. Let's remain committed to those things. Hope that encourages you today and challenges you in your walk in faith with him. These are unique days, what we serve a unique God, in fact, the one and only. And we pray that all that we do and say and think would be to his honor and glory. Until tomorrow, friends, God bless.